Okay, y'all. Back towards Walmart for the second time of the day. It's 2:15 in the afternoon. Uh-oh. Why am I getting a warning sitting on my car? Oh, my trunk is not closed. Hold on, y'all. Oh, shit. Honey, thank goodness this darn gone car notifies me of everything. Shoot, and then there's another car coming my way. Let me put my flashes on. Oh, shoot, y'all. My darn gone trunk is not... I told y'all I just got finished coming from the store. Okay, that done did everything. I love this darn gone Nissan, y'all. It just tells me everything, y'all. Okay, now on the road we go. Like I said, second time to Walmart, but I'm going to the Chick-fil-A that's right in front of it on the DoorDash. DoorDash was dead this morning because everybody done took all the shifts and stuff. I got a trick for that behind. I done scheduled myself for the first time in over 2 months. So, I will be dashing tomorrow on a full 8-hour shift for 11 to 9. That way I can take advantage of all them peak times that towards the end of breakfast, lunch, and towards dinner. I just got to make sure to keep my energy. I guess I take 4 spirulina tablets tomorrow. Y'all know I tend to darn gonna give out about around the 2-hour mark. So let's hope that I can successfully do a solid that's gonna be a solid 8 hours. That's 4 times more than what I'm used to doing. The maximum that I've done at one time is like 4 hours straight. I might need to at least I'm going to try to do my best. Even if I had to take a little break in between and come back. The goal is I want to at least try to strive to do 6 hours tomorrow, and that'll bring my dash time up to like, well, I can't say what it'll bring it up to because I'm dashing now and I don't know how much I'm going to do today, but excluding the day, 6 hours tomorrow will bring me up to 11 hours for the week. The most that I've ever done in a week is like 17 hours. And then sometime in March, I'm going to try to see what 30 hours a week of dashing looks like. Providing if I'm not doing anything. Because currently, I'm looking into these jobs where I can be. But one is third shift. I done lost the contact information for it. I got to find it. But it's overnight assisting people with scheduling for COVID. But that's from 9 at night to 9 in the morning. So I don't know how that's going to fare. But then there's another one through Concentrics, which I could never, for whatever reason, that is like the toughest job to get is Concentrics. Maybe they'll hire me now considering that it's for COVID as opposed to, you know, Apple products. But the thing is, with Concentrics, though, they send you your computer, but I already got a computer. So it's like, and then my room ain't but so big. So it's like, oh my goodness. I got to look at that and see if, because normally they send you your computer. Hopefully I can get it without them sending me my computer. Because like I said, I don't have no space for another computer. I'm trying to think, what else was it at? Oh, it was another one through Imani, which I'm already signed on to. I can pick any available job on their platform. That's the one where I seen they was also doing COVID testing, I believe. And it was $13 an hour for any hours worked under 13. I mean, under 25. And but if you work 25 hours or more, then it would become $14 an hour. And if you're bilingual, which I am actually polylingual, but unfortunately, as per usual, that day, I swear I'm going to sign up for Babbel, honey. Babbel currently got like a 65% discount. Hell, maybe they bring that into Black History Month. Shit, I need to go ahead and start finally learning some Spanish. Every time they call for a bilingual darn gone translator, I be darn gone raise my hand and they say Espanol, I be like, that darn gone Spanish gets me every time. Every night again, they have one for French. I don't never get nothing for Italian. I don't get not Jack, sugar, honey, iced tea for Italian. Every now and again, I might get something for French. But Spanish is the most common. So I'm going to finally commit to learning Spanish this year. Now, I don't know how it's going to work with this. Well, shit, I do pretty good with my darn gone French. But once again, that's only because, you know, I don't know. I guess I could try to perfect my Spanish. But, you know, Spanish, y'all be rolling y'all R's and stuff. And I don't know how that's going to do. Like, they be rolling certain letters. I don't know if my tongue is able to do all that, honey. But I'm going to try my best to commit to it. Oh, it is windy out here, honey. The street signs are, I mean, the signal signs are just as shaking. The Stoplight Chronicles, honey. What it's like to be at a stoplight. Here we go. I'm supposed to pick up by, you know, 2:33. You know, usually it's always a wait line at darn going Chick-fil-A. Stop at another light, y'all. Oh, this one wasn't as long. But yeah, that's what's going on with me, y'all. Just dashing until I find something in between time, and then it'll lower my dash time. Oh my goodness, I'm gonna get stopped at every. Okay, this one done turned green. I'm about to say, now god darn now. Is every single light gonna catch me? I ain't gonna get there until like 2:33. It's currently 2:24 now, and I'm 2 miles away from Walmart. But there's like a stoplight every darn on 1,000 feet. Every 1,000 feet there's a stoplight. Y'all think I'm a kidding. There's literally another one right here. And then 1,000 feet up there's another one. Oh my goodness. Is there anything else to share with y'all? Because I don't think I'm going to be doing too much DoorDash and vlog today. Matter of fact, this is going to be a hybrid of a DoorDash vlog in addition to me just, you know, shooting the sugar honey iced tea with y'all. I don't know. Y'all tell me how y'all enjoying these conversational DoorDash vlogs. Do y'all want, just like to see the orders, or do y'all like it better when I just go impromptu and start shooting the shit with y'all? Oh, shit. Why'd I get on this side knowing damn well I got to make a turn? I do that every time. Because every time I come over here, I'm so used to turning straight to go to Walmart, right? So I always get in this lane. And knowing damn well when I need to go to Chick-fil-A, I needed to be on the other side, y'all. So I know. I know he over there looking like, who in the hell is she talking to? I don't think they can see that the camera's on, y'all. Let me get my DoorDash bag ready. Oh, it don't look like it's that crowded over there. Look like we might be in and out, y'all. But anyways, I'll be back when I get over there, y'all. How about she forced me to come over here where it's now difficult for me to get out? I'm over here on the inner side, so it's like now with the car behind me, I can't just zip out once I get my order. Now, DoorDash has since updated the app and said to use the drive-thru line for the Dasher, and that's what I've been complaining about, that we should have our own drive-thru, right? But I don't see what they're talking about, because it looked like both sides are being utilized by the customer. I wish they had a side just for us Dashers. Not that it would make much of a difference, because it looked like either side is just as long, Lord Jesus. Not. Oh, wait a minute. Now why am I seeing that people are able to go into the place now? Oh, now y'all know I'm gonna have some shit to say soon as I get from this line. Oh, wait a minute. There's people dining in as well. Oh my goodness. There's people actually dining inside the restaurant now. Like, what in the world really going on? I haven't even paid attention to the cars parked on the side, y'all. There's actually patrons in the darn going, y'all know I'm about to complain, right? So, just wait till I get out of this line. Matter of fact, I'm going to complain while I'm still in this line. I'm just waiting till she get my, get me in the system, and then I'm gonna roll this window up. Oh, it's about to rain too.
Hi, can I get a name for your order?
Rectavious D. It's a DoorDash.
Okay, can I see the screen, please?
They know what they be doing. now all of a sudden, now y'all seen how many times I've done came to this darn on Chick-fil-A right now. Granted, in her defense, this person did have a very particular name. You know, y'all heard the name, right? No shade to my customer. And for hell, my name is quite awkward too, but honey, Rectavious, you know you got quite the name, honey. So I didn't necessarily, I'm going to give her a pass on asking me to pull up the full screen. My thing is this, they should just do like McDonald's and go by code numbers instead. Especially with them being a Southern Christian darn gone based company, right? Y'all values people's privacies and stuff. Well, y'all should have darn gone, oh my God, y'all, it is the cow. Oh my God, I wish y'all could see this. They got the mascot out here, y'all. Hello. They literally got darn gold. Come on through. I wish y'all could have seen that. They literally got the guy out here in the darn gold. I guess, well, it's about to rain, so he had to get from outside the road. Now, out of all the times that I've been here, this is the first time I'm seeing them have the mascot. Now, y'all know I've been coming here since September. Now, they've had the mascot before. It's just this the first time I'm seeing the mascot since I've been dashing. But, yeah, all of a sudden, they want to ask for me to show the screen. They know damn well when I show the full screen, it turns the camera off. Oh, but, yeah, let's get into this complaint. Oh, look at the dog. Oh, see, the dog, I was going to flash this camera over here. He done jumped to the other side of the window. Oh, shoot, it's 2 minutes after my customer's pickup time. See, he done flashed through the other side of the window. He keep jumping from window to window, y'all. Oh, he's over there on the opposite side of the window. Oh, here he come back. Nope. Oh, there you go. No. But yeah. Now, Chick-fil-A, I got another problem with y'all. Now, it was one thing when y'all didn't allow nobody to enter the establishment. But now I'm trying to figure out, now that people are able to go into the establishment, because I'm seeing people sit down and coming out with their orders and stuff, why am I stuck in the drive-thru? And y'all know I'm definitely going to ask, if I'm able to walk in and pick up my customer's order now that y'all are able to have. I'm definitely going to ask that. Because I know damn well they ain't going to tell us that we got to be forced to go through the drive-thru. And y'all are able to have people come up in there. Now, I've had other stores that I go to, like Hooters, to tell me to go to the side or whatever, but it's a dedicated pickup, right? Oh, y'all see the Kyle over there on the side. But, like I was saying, y'all seen me go to Hooters and places like that where, the dog looking like, what in the world? I don't know whether to bark or what. But anyways, child is darn gonna dance a cow and storm me for a loop punning. But yeah, they tell me go to the side or whatever while other customers are able to go in, but at least we have our own dedicated darn going pickup area. But it's like I'm going through the regular drive through. It's now 4 minutes past the darn gone pickup time. And I'm now about to be running late by no fault of my own. And now that people are able to go into the establishment, I'm trying to figure out why can't y'all have a certain table like the Chick-fil-A. I wish I knew the street, but it's like going towards downtown. There's this Chick-fil-A that I go to that's all the way on the opposite side of town. They allow us to come in. So this is not Chick-fil-A across the board. Let me just say this. This is not Chick-fil-A across the board. Because I go to the Chick-fil-A all the way on the opposite side of town for my customers. And they have a section where we can go in. It's only this Chick-fil-A right here on Ramsey Street. And once again, I can't wait till the review come up, honey. Soon as the review come up, oh, I'm going to leave a nasty complaint. Oh, and matter of fact, depending on their answer, I might darn gone also put a Yelp review. I don't go out my way to do a Yelp review. I always do the Google reviews. Oh, but honey, if they tell me that we have to continue going through this drive-thru and y'all got this darn gone dining room open to the regular folks, oh, I'm going to leave a old nice and long, nasty darn gone Yelp review, honey. Because like I said, this is ridiculous. I'm 5 minutes after the pickup time. I damn sure about to ask them. Honey, she looked at me like she already know. She already know the question's coming. Give me the side out. So I don't want to give you something to give me a side out over. Hello. Rectavia Steve. Oh, okay. So they know I'm doing that one. Child, I wish I could see her, the way she looked at me, like if looks could kill. Girl, don't get mad at me.
What was her name?
Rectavia Steve.
Did you ever do that?
Yes. Girl got an attitude, not the one y'all just saw, but this one that's walking up. That one right there. See, y'all get to see all this in real time, y'all. And this is why we got to have our cameras on at all times for myths like this. Rectavia Steve?
Okay, sorry. I'm so
tired. It's understandable. Okay. Now, girl, I can't help that you out here in the darn gone cold, but girl, I can feel that attitude through the darn gone, through the mask. And like I said, I know how it is, because I used to work at Chick-fil-A. I understand that, you know, so sometimes it be one of them days, but you can't let the darn gone customer know that you pissed off. Especially since you on the front line. See, me, I work back of the house. So the days I was pissed off, you know, the customer didn't feel that because they didn't see me. Because I could position my face at the fry station where they never saw my face, especially when we wore the mask. So they could never see, you know, they never got the feel when I was peed off. But girl, you working front line customer service. And like I said, from a former Chick-fil-A worker to a current one, honey, I don't know why she giving me this hostility. I can't help that you out here working in the damn cold. Meanwhile, I'm 11 minutes after the pickup time. It's 12:44. And meanwhile, cars behind me are somehow getting their darn old orders before me. See, this is what we be talking about as dashers. See this car that just passed me? Mean they got put in the system before, after me. So I'm trying to figure out. And then here's the thing with DoorDash. By the time we even get the order, the restaurant done had the order for at least 5 minutes. And then it took me over 5 minutes to get here. So y'all had over 10 minutes to prepare my order. And yet cars that is coming after me are getting their orders before me. It's just no respect for the dasher. And no respect for the customer who orders. It's like the customer who orders through these these delivery services for me to deliver. We don't get no respect. It is now 2:45. My order post been ready at 2:33. Just no respect, y'all. Here she come, y'all. You too. See, she ain't even give me time to darn gonna ask about the drive-thru. Y'all see that? It just dropped. What happened to the My Pleasure? Just a complete darn gone witch, honey. Y'all see that dry ass? Here you go. Girl, what I done to you, whore? You know, I had me waiting darn gone 18 minutes after the damn pickup time and shit. Let me see. Oh my god, a pure car accident, y'all, out here. Oh shit. Oh Lord. Well, I be damn. Oh damn. How the hell did that shit happen? Lord, the ambulance and everything coming out here, y'all. Anyway, let me get to my oh my goodness. Non-driving asses? How the hell y'all get in a car accident at the turning of Walmart? This is just an awkward day right here. The ambulance is literally coming at the turn. See this Ramsey Street? When I tell y'all, no Southern hospitality when it comes to driving. Cause tell me how in the hell y'all get in a car accident at the turning of Walmart. Child, boo. I tell you, the Southern hospitality just goes out the window when it comes to driving on the road and when it comes to us dashers with some of these restaurants. Y'all got the scene in real time. Y'all got the scene in real time, the difficulty of me getting this order. But anyways, let me go ahead and type that I got it in. Okay, y'all, I'm back. So I'm supposed to be dropping this off by 2:55. Thank goodness for the long windows. DoorDash is starting to learn. Once again, I think they be taking our feedback into consideration. And I always complain about that drive-thru whenever I go through Chick-fil-A. So now they add the extra time to compensate for it. Because now I'm still going to be within my time window to drop off the customer's order. Because they're just, according to GPS, 5 minutes away, and it's 2:50 right now. And of course, I got to take into account about 2 to 3 minutes to find the house, depending on You know, sometimes it don't be a straight shot, especially if it be apartments and shit. But I can't get over that old funky darn old hell heifer, honey. Tell me, have a nice day. See, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Girl, you talking to somebody who have a degree in marketing, but even if I didn't have a degree in marketing, honey, the average person could have picked up on your tone of voice, honey. That dry, have a nice day. Now, once again, I wasn't the bitch in Chick-fil-A that was for the my pleasure either. I thought that was doing a little bit too much, especially if it's a day where I don't feel like saying my pleasure. It was mandatory. I was the one that was always defiant, but the reason why they never got on me at Chick-fil-A, when I worked at the Chick-fil-A at the Federal State University, if you want to know specifically, just in case you come across this video, honey, and my darn gone supervisors will tell you, I ain't never had no complaints. Everybody darn gone loved my personality, even when I had an off date. Because, number one, I checked my attitude at the door. Whatever I was going through, I never darn gonna let it off on the customer. Because it wasn't their fault. Especially the bullshit that we had to go through at the Federal State University, honey. But, yeah. I never was one to say my pleasure. But I would say, you're welcome. Have a nice day. But once again, the tone of which I said it, it wasn't condescending. And because once again, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. And like I said, that darn gone dry ass darn gone here you go or whatever. Oh, child, if you don't sit down somewhere and get you an Olaplex treatment, I know something. I could tell she had a beautiful, good grade of curly darn on hair if it wasn't overprocessed with darn on store brought dye. Like that darn on four different shades of mother freaking color. Girl, number one, get your darn on hair straight before
in a quarter mile, straight. Turn right onto Langdon Street.
Here you is, darn on getting darn on rattle up at me. Ooh. Am I doing the most, y'all? Is my reaction too much? But like I said, I just felt that.
Take the second right onto Langdon Street.
Girl, gonna catch an attitude with me. And like I said, y'all didn't see everything that I get to see. Like I
continue
said,
continue on Langdon Street for half a mile.
I can't wait till I get this darn gone. Y'all think y'all be seeing certain stuff with this darn gone phone. Oh, just wait till I get the dash cam up in this bitch, honey. Wait till y'all get to actually see what I be fully seeing. Like I said, that shit irritated out of 165 dashes. I've had rude darn gone customers and I mean rude stores or whatever, because I ain't never encountered a rude customer, strangely enough, after 160 some that. Well, I had some that was somewhat rude, but not noticeably too rude.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto Seabrook Road.
But yeah, I've had some rude stores, including the Walmart on McDonald's on Murchison Road. Child, I wish they bring that Walmart back on Murchison Road, but I've had, you know, the rude...
Take the next right onto Seabrook Road.
I had rude darn gone workers or whatever at the McDonald's. But not
blatant. In a quarter mile, turn right onto Spalding Street.
But not blatant like that. Like that's just doing too much. That bitch actually, I swear, y'all, I'm really turned up. That bitch actually had the audacity to roll her eyes at me. Y'all would have thought that I did something personally to her. She literally rolled her eyes at ooh. Woosah wad, woosah. I still can't get over the fact that out of all my dashes, this helpful literally rolled her eyes at me like, this bitch.
Take the next right onto Spalding Street, then your destination will be on the right.
To whoever I'm delivering to, I'm sorry that you had to wait. Well, shoot, it's just $2.55 now. You ain't had to wait that damn long.
Your destination is on the right.
Black Lives Matter in the yard. My type of neighborhood. But anyways, let me see where my customer address is at. Okay, y'all, that was weird. It said it was a contactless delivery, which posed to trigger the camera to come up. When you click complete delivery, the camera posed to automatically come on. So I don't understand why it didn't do that this time. Because once again, it said leave at the door. But I guess somehow the customer, even though he notated that, it was in the system as like a handed to me delivery. So when it's a handed to me delivery, it doesn't trigger the camera when you click complete delivery. So I had to just take a photo just in case, because once again, we in one of those neighborhoods where somebody would claim that, you know, you didn't darn gonna deliver, especially when they do stuff like that. I think some of the folks be doing shit like that on purpose. They wait till our car get gone. See, he couldn't do that with me because my car was still here. But, you know, in some cases, not to say he would have done it, but what would happen is they know what they be doing sometimes with the customer. They'll say one thing on the in the description and then choose another thing when it comes to actually saying contactless delivery or hand it to me. And it trips us up. And like I said, if the customer was to say they ain't got their delivery and you ain't took no photo because the camera didn't come on, honey, now it's he say, she say. That's why I still take my darn gone photo regardless in situations like that. But now I'm calmed down a little bit, y'all. But ooh, that darn gone red-headed darn gone ratchet ass hold on got me turned up today. That heifer got me turned all the way the hell up. Have a nice day. I sure will have a nice day in spite of your darn old heifer ass. I about want to call her a bitch, but that'll be an insult to dogs everywhere, honey, because even dogs have darn old common manners. So I won't even dare insult the dog species by calling her a darn old bitch, because like I said, that would darn old be too complimentary for her darn old. See, a heifer don't got no darn on manners. A dog do, so I can't even call her no darn on bitch. But anyways, y'all, that is my darn on day in a nutshell. It done turned left that darn on quick with that darn on. Ooh, I can't wait. Like I said, I can't wait till the review come up. I'm gonna leave an old nasty review for her behind. Matter of fact, they getting darn gone 2 stars for this shit. And the only reason they getting 2 stars is for the other darn gone woman being actually nice and shit. But if it was up to her, honey, I'd give them bitches a 1 star. I would give them 0 stars if it was possible. But that is it, y'all. I know this is going to sound ironic to say like, comment, share, subscribe on a rant video, but feel free to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I will see y'all soon, hopefully with more positive videos.